r/am I the a-hole? Am I the a-hole for calling my girlfriend a gold digger? I'm a 29-year-old guy who finished residency 2 ago and am now a pediatrician making 160k. I got tired of being single for most of my life, so I downloaded a few dating apps and met this girl, 26, who works in customer service for a huge company about 9 months ago. We hit it off and officially became exclusive 3 months ago. Overall, she's a really great person, but there's a few things about her that bother me, and I'm not really sure if it's normal or not because I've never really been in an actual serious relationship. I always pay for everything on dates. I know that I make more than her and it doesn't necessarily hurt me to always pay, but she doesn't ever offer to pay or split the bill and she just expects me to always pay. The first time she came over to my apartment, she was literally shocked. I live in a shitty one-bedroom apartment because I want to pay off my student loans as fast as possible, so I still basically live like a broke college student. She kept making comments about how I should move out and find a nicer place that suits a doctor. She wanted to introduce me to her family right away. I thought the relationship is too new to meet the parents, but she insisted. And when we went to their house, her parents only asked about my job and salary. When we went out and ran into someone she knows, she introduced me as her doctor boyfriend. These things, plus some other stuff, made me realize she doesn't really care about me, just that I'm a doctor. So I told her. She blew up, saying I'm insulting her and calling her a gold digger, and that she's just proud of me for being successful. Am I the a-hole? NTA, but you should usually break up with someone that you think is a gold digger instead of calling them a gold digger. He didn't call her a gold digger though. He told her he felt like she only cares about his title status, and she responded by saying, "Oh, you think I'm a gold digger? That's how it looks from the post." NTA, it appears you didn't even use the term gold digger, but rather your girlfriend inferred it hastily. Dump her. You can do so much better. In the future, don't tell potential partners you're a doctor. In fact, I'd scrub my social media presence of any indicators if I were you. In theory, that will eliminate the vast majority of people who are only after your money and or status. Just keep living that fire lifestyle. I mean, the title is literally, "Am I the a-hole for calling my girlfriend a gold digger?" So I assume at some point he said that to her. Otherwise, saying "am I the a-hole for implying my girlfriend is a gold digger" would be more accurate. Or maybe, "am I the a-hole for making my girlfriend think she's a gold digger?" Either way, based on how OP titled the post and how the girlfriend reacted, it appears that he thought she might be a gold digger and made that thought clear to her. You could have asked her why she wasn't paying for dates if it bothered you. "When my fiancé made more money than me, he paid for things a lot, and now that I am making more than him, I pay for things a lot more. It could be that it's because she's more strapped for cash and is more traditional, but either way it's something you could ask about splitting in a way that's proportional to your income. I think asking how much you make is a little weird, but introducing you to her parents early on really has no bearing on how serious she views the relationship. Some people just include their families in things more than others. Lastly, people still really respect medicine as a profession. It's definitely possible she's just excited and proud of you. When I was in grad school, the subject of my research was apparently really exciting to people and my fiancé always brought it up. I hated it because I hated talking about my research, and I didn't like feeling like he was doing it just to show off. And I guess in a way he was, but he was just really proud of me and loved that my obscure background was apparently interesting to people. I'm going to say no a-holes here because you can't really read her mind and she can't really read yours. It depends on what you actually told her, but I'll give you both the benefit of the doubt. Are you too sensitive about it? Maybe. Is she a gold digger? Maybe. I'm not convinced either way. Don't date someone who works in customer service while you're making 160k a year and be shocked when you end up paying for everything. She is probably barely scraping by with her job. I don't know anyone in customer service who makes a decent living. Info: what are her future aspirations? Does she also have big career plans? Just because she is making considerably less now doesn't mean it will always be like that. For real, how ignorant can a person be? Info: does she ask for gifts and gets upset when you refuse to spend money on her, or are you only paying for dinners dates? Paying for dates may be just her being traditional. for lack of a better word, especially if you never asked her to pay for her half or indicated she should offer to pay. I can see her just going with the flow. While I've gone Dutch on most of my first dates, I know some men were offended that I pulled my wallet out or would insist on paying, so the idea that the man pays is still very prevalent. You can't blame her for her parents' comments. They are their own people. Though that tidbit could give insight on how she was raised to value prestige and money in a partner. So far, most of the things you listed don't seem to be so controversial or weird. It's common to introduce people by their occupation, though not necessary, since a lot of people consider their occupation a huge chunk of their identity, the house thing. While frankly none of her business this early into the relationship, is a game not really gold-digging behavior emo. If she had said, "Move into a better, nicer place so I can live with you," that'd be one thing. If all she said was, "You make enough money to live somewhere nicer than your self-admittedly shitty apartment," that can be her not understanding your financial situation or priorities. She sounds superficial, but nothing except not paying for dates indicates gold-digging behavior emo. I'm leaning towards you being the R on this one. Itta. So what, she's proud of having a boyfriend who's a doctor? That doesn't make her a gold digger. And she doesn't like your broke college student style apartment, which I imagine most girls wouldn't either. What kind of background does she come from? While it's rude that the parents asked about your salary, it's understandable that parents want their children to date someone successful. I make significantly more than my so and I almost always pay for things on dates. We've had the conversation in the past, and while I know she would love to contribute more, she's not really in a position to do so. Itta. I don't see any of this as evidence that she is a gold digger. Honestly, more likely she's impressed that you're a pediatrician, which could imply that you're smart, ambitious, and caring. Why did you insult her rather than having a mature conversation about money? Itta. A bit. I think you jumped to conclusions due to your inexperience. Can you square that? Overall, she's a really great person, and plus some other stuff made me realize she doesn't really care about me if the only evidence of her being a gold digger is always paying. Well, you should be able to talk about that and ask her to pay for some dates. But it's not evidence enough of being a gold digger. Some relationships have one person always pay BC of gender norms or because of a financial split. Also, this is my girlfriend. She's a lawyer at Exo. This is my boyfriend. He works at a non-profit is a pretty standard introduction in my circles. I think it's weird that people with money or status can sometimes look down on people intrigued or impressed by their money and status. If you want someone that's not impressed with your money, get with another doctor or a heiress. It makes no sense for you to date a girl that works at a call center and turn around and try to shame her for being impressed. No a-holes here, which is possibly unpopular opinion. But I can see an alternate reason for all of these things you've listed. Maybe she was raised not to pay, or to expect men to pay, and doesn't realize it's rude. Maybe she's shocked because your apartment is scary gross and because she thinks you shouldn't be living like a college kid, not because it's not lavish. Maybe her parents are nosy without that being a reflection on her, and maybe she actually is proud of you. Maybe it's cringe. But I've def bragged about my husband before. Not because he does well, but because I'm legitimately impressed by him. I can't tell what she's doing exactly from your info here. I know doctors can be really sensitive to this stuff because they are worried about being taken advantage of. It's somewhat possible your own insecurity is pushing her away. I don't know. I'm just inferring from what you've written here. Either way, if you have deep concerns about compatibility, you break up with her or maybe be clearer about your expectations from her as your partner. Itta. Look, I think it's pretty common to want to meet the parents pretty early on if they are serious about you. And as far as her making comments about your shitty apartment, she's really just giving you her opinion on what she would do in your situation. If my girlfriend was making good money with a super stable job and didn't upgrade to a nicer place, I'd put my 2 cents in all the time. As far as introducing you by your job or what you're doing in life, I feel like that's not even close to out of the ordinary. You're definitely overthinking it. That being said, it's not something you should never think about. Take care to always reflect on your life and the things going on around you. After all, we are only human. It's in everyone's nature to be selfish and try to gain something with every action, even if done without consciously deciding so. Am I the a-hole for making a woman who has very little money repay me $3,800? About 6 months ago, a woman drove off a very busy road, up into the parking lot at my work, and hit my truck. She must have been going at least 40 miles per hour and hit directly on the wheel of my truck because it turned my truck 90 degrees with very little visible body damage. To top it off, she had no insurance. After all was said and done, she caused about $18,000 in damage, for which I had to pay out of pocket about $3,800. Deductible. Rental car. Repair costs my a-hole insurance company refused to pay. Additionally, since she didn't have insurance, I can't recover the diminished value of my truck, which I think is at least $5,000 that I will never get back. Obviously this amount will go down as my truck ages, but I'm pretty much stuck with this vehicle for a while now, or I have to eat that cost. I had just gotten this new truck about 4 months prior and had to deal with this nearly every day for the 7 weeks it took to get repaired. It was a nightmare and very stressful dealing with this. I ended up suing her in small claims court and won by default because she did not show up. I feel like she wasn't planning on repaying me until she was trying to get her license reinstated. Unfortunately, the state is requiring her to have a repayment plan with me before she can get her license back. She has agreed to repay me $100 every other week until paid in full. So far, I have received one such payment with the next due today. Now the part where I sort of feel like an a-hole is that my wife and I make about $225,000 per year combined, and after this lady sent me her statement of assets through the court, she has about $200 to her name and makes $400 per week as a waitress. I paid the $3,800 and sort of moved on financially. It is a lot of money, but we can afford it. She very obviously owes me the money, but the $100 every other week very clearly would mean a lot more to her financially than me. What say you? NTA. Driving without insurance is unacceptable for anyone. What would have happened if you had been in the truck and were left permanently disabled? Who would have paid for your care? It's also very illegal. Not as illegal as you think. Insurance is a state law, not a federal one. And there are states, New Hampshire for example, that don't require insurance. Having insurance is still smart, just not having it isn't automatically illegal. NTA. She caused an accident through her bad driving, and was driving with no insurance. She's is the person responsible for damaging your truck, and is the one responsible for the sum your insurance didn't cover. Hard up though she will no doubt be, she broke the law and she should pay for the damage she caused. It will also teach her that she should improve her driving and insure her car. It seems apparent there is no money to insure her car with. OP seems like a decent person to be concerned. I think in his place I'd write it off and collect the good karma. NTA. But if you're concerned, and you are, you sound like a decent person. Maybe work out something with her that wouldn't be as crippling to her. Legally and morally she has to pay for what she broke. But you as the victim can be as lenient or as hard as you want. If you're concerned about her situation, maybe reach out and renegotiate a lower payment. But it sounds like she agreed, so maybe she makes better tips as a waitress than she wanted to tell the court. NTA, because you're being reasonable. Clearly this woman is TAFE hitting your car. I don't want you to feel like TAFE or asking what's fair. She doesn't deserve to get off scot-free, but is chasing her down to make a $100 payment for a year and a half worth the headache? You can advocate for principle, or you can advocate for the value of your own time. It sounds like a lose-lose, so it's your call. No real wrong answers here. No a-holes here. But, I would applaud and respect you as a person for doing good for someone else, and for giving the debt out of kindness and awareness of her situation. Not that you're obligated to in any way. Seeing that you've already moved on financially though, it would clearly mean a whole lot more to her than it does to you. Emotional arbitrage, the best of investments. Godspeed. NTA. Being poor doesn't mean there aren't consequences to your actions. It also seems like keeping her off the road might not be a bad thing if she's driving without insurance badly enough to lose her license. Finally, if she wanted to request your goodwill or forgiveness, she should have done so before she stiffed you and not after the state enforced a payment plan to get her license back. I mean it, or even though you are legally 100% in the right, she ducked up and did hit your car, but she's also being taken to the cleaners while she's already struggling. Not saying you don't have a right to compensation, but you are also a bit of an a-hole. I can't believe how few it answers there are. Like, yes, legally you're in the right, but come on, ducking someone over financially is not nice. The question wasn't, is she an a-hole for driving without insurance? The question was, is he TAFE for making a woman pay money she can ill afford, that they don't need, but she unavoidably owes? Being an a-hole isn't about legal, it's about ethical and moral. So yes, ITA for taking what you don't need from someone that can't afford it. OP has a choice: be kind, empathetic, and forgiving, or be legalistic and individualistic. That being said, if she was an a-hole about it, drunk, or other mitigating circumstances, you could at least make the everyone sucks here argument that the $$$$ is a bi-weekly reminder that her choices have consequences. But we don't have any of that info. NTA, you drive dangerously, then that's what happens. She's just lucky nobody got hurt. NTA and the dangerous driving is what bothers me. Although OP could be a good guy and forgive the debt, how would it solve the problem of her reckless driving? Barreling into a parking lot at 40 miles an hour is hard to justify. She could kill someone next time. Having a hard life does not mean someone is automatically a sin. Edit: my hard life family produced some saints, some in-betweens, and some devils. Be careful with the devils. Ro, you made it to the end. You're a ducking beast. I'll cut you a deal. Smash like and subscribe for more curated content, mate. It's free and that's a great price.